attack Abu Yeshu before they get a chance to move.
Well, we'll have to be stronger than we are right now.
Have you seen Karen?
I sent them all a bit hours ago.
Where's my assignment?
Patrol Gandafna while we move out. I want to be sure they don't surprise us while we're surprising them. David will jump them from the rear, and my group will attack directly through the olive grove. David, you'd better take Jordana with you. She knows the village.
Seems to be moving over there.
The Muezzin hasn't called for the morning prayers either.
Cover us.
Somebody come and help me cut him down.
This is Taha, Mukhtar of Abu Yesha. And this is Karen, secretary of the Rooms Committee, Bungalow 12, Gandafna. We have no Qadi to pray for Taha's soul, and we have no rabbi to pray over Karen. Taha should have lived a long life, surrounded by his people and his sons. And death should have come to him as an old friend offering the gift of sleep. It came instead as a maniac. And Karen, who loved her life and who lived it as purely as a flame, why did God forget her? Why did she have to stumble onto death so young and all alone and in the dark? Well, we of all people should no longer be surprised when death reaches out to us. With the world's insanity and our own slaughtered millions, we should be used to senseless killing. But I am not used to it. I cannot get used to it, and I will not get used to it. I look at these two people, and I want to howl like a dog. I want to shout murder, so that the whole world will hear it and never forget it. It's right that these two people should lie side by side in this grave, because they will share it in peace. But the dead always share the earth in peace, and that's not enough. It's time for the living to have a turn. A few miles from here, there are people who are fighting and dying, and we must join them. But I swear, on the bodies of these two people, that the day will come when Arab and Jew will share in a peaceful life this land that they have always shared in death. Taha, old friend, and very dear brother, Karen, child of light, daughter of Israel. Shalom.